Hello friends, in this video we will be working on installing a VMware converter and already a V2V virtual to virtual migration of a machine. So we will look at prerequisites and post checklist for a migration. So first we will install VMware converter. So I'm using VMware converter 6.0. I have downloaded from VMware site. It's a free tool, so no license is required. So for we can directly install on a server which we want to migrate the server, or you can install on any jump box and you can use it. So we'll go ahead and install the converter. So if you want to migrate any 2003 box or any older version, I recommend to use 6.0 and below version of converters, whereas if you go for a 6.2 converter, it is not compatible with for 2003. Click next. So this is a local installation. It is completed. It took 10 minutes. The average speed is 16.95. We'll go to vCenter and see. Okay, so go to console. P2V is successful, but we have VMs with the same name and IP, so we will change the IP and host name. Okay, to DHCP. In production, like we will be powering up the source machine, so we won't be changing any name and IP. If required, then only we will be changing the name and IP of the VM. So here we change the virtual machine name, but whereas when you check in the data store, the name will be like PS1 for the folders. So for that we need to do a storage vmotion to any other data store. Once you storage vmotion the virtual machine, the name of the VM folder will be updated to new one. So server looks fine. Generally, if you do P2V, like you need to delete the hidden drivers and hidden devices in the device manager, but I will show you. Okay, we have rebooted the server. So the computer name is changed. So we were discussing, like, if you do a P2V, like what we need to do is we need to go to device manager and view show hidden file, hidden devices. When you enable the show hidden devices, you'll be able to see a couple of offline devices here which you need to select and uninstall. As this is V2V, we won't be seeing such type of hidden devices. If it is a physical to virtual conversion, you'll be able to see a couple of hidden devices here which we need to uninstall, or else we will be facing performance issues after the migration. As well as apart from this, we need to uninstall the all physical server related like drivers, Dell drivers or HP drivers as monitoring tools, all these things. Or else they will simply eat up your resources on the server. Along with that, we need to update the VMware tools once the P2V is done, so that we will get a good performance. So that's all.